What's the future of e-mobility? Somebody who knows about this is Sabine Scheunert, Vice President IT of Mercedes. Good morning.
Good morning, Miriam.
One of my favorite words regarding e-mobility is range anxiety. What is that and why do we fear range anxiety?
Yeah, so when we analyzed a little bit the market, we found out very quickly that in particular in Germany, people are anxious about their range. So is an electric car still fitting to my daily life? And therefore we launched the EQ Ready app, which we brought out in the App Store in Frankfurt during the Frankfurt Motor Show last year. And it's exactly addressing that topic. So people have that anxiety, as you said it, in terms of is electric really, is that a true alternative to my current combustion engine? And what we see is we have thousands of people downloading the app at the moment.
In Germany?
In Germany, and checking out whether an electric car could fit already today in my private life. And don't be surprised, but it fits. And often this anxiety is really not addressed in a right way. We see that, for example, in China, where people are not asking this question in such a frequent way, and therefore, well, but we addressed that pain point here in Germany in particular, and happy to have that EQ Ready app. But
so anxiety in Germany is kind of a business model.
No, I think it's not a business model, but it's by trying to identify a pain point and then by bringing out a digital service in terms of helping people in overcome that.
If we talk about e-mobility, we are talking about batteries, we are talking about range, we are talking about designing electrical cars. Don't we need to talk more about a mobility concept of the future that will totally change how we move around?
Absolutely. I think you are addressing a very, very important point. People will live for many, many years in a kind of hybrid model. We will have people still having exclusive views of cars, but also people more and more searching for shared mobility offers. And so we are convinced that it's all about having a platform somehow, then in the end, being able to integrate all those mobility demands, either it is exclusive or more shared. And I think the one who is going to bring that or to make it live and real is going to somehow also have a finger on the pulse in terms of shaping then the mobility offer of the future.
We were at the Ada Lovelace Festival here in Berlin, and it's about women in tech. How many women, what's the percentage of women that help you build that platform?
Yeah, so I have currently 30%, more than 30%, okay. In my team, in my responsibility, area of responsibility. I'm quite glad because this is not the number that you have, unfortunately, still in tech. So I'm trying to utilize my role. So I have that decent position, and I think it's really up to us in helping women to kind of dare to enter this industry, in also bringing their candidatures across. So therefore I also opened this, or kind of finished the Ada Lovelace presentation this morning by offering a mentorship. And I think it's all about, again, by having the diversity. It's not having more and more women, it's having diverse people, colleagues working in an organization in terms of, again, bringing up ideas with regards to women and men. I think this is all about by having the beauty of diversity.
What do you personally learn from women in your field of expertise regarding building this e-mobility platform?
Mm-hmm. What I see and I experience is that, without being too stereotype, women have a lot of empathy. And the way of how they work, and in particular when you're creating a platform like a car and customer platform, you need to collaborate between divisions, between classical line functions. And often women have that extremely talent in overcoming specific obstacles by having that empathy, feeling about the situation, and then still trying to drive rather the functional topic and not probably the political topics that we for sure still have in big companies in our size.
Collaboration instead of anxiety. Thanks, Sabine.
Thank you, Miriam.